Hi, my name is Robin Sayed. I'm a solution architect manager out of Seattle, Washington, working with the customer T-Mobile here today. We're going to go through the RAN optimization chatbot this morning, and it is a process optimization tool that they've used to improve their efficiencies for their RAN optimization team. So RAN engineers have to create MOPs to add features to the network, to add capacity to the network, and this takes an extensive amount of time and research. There are 3GPP documentations they have to research, vendor documentation they have to research, and also an understanding the configuration that they currently have in the network. When they do this, it takes a lot of time, and this tool is going to help them improve upon that. Also, when they implement things in the evenings and the network operations team has to execute a MOP, they don't have someone to ask questions to. So the team who actually requested that we create this tool is the team who didn't want to be woken up anymore from the engineers that ran into unforeseen consequences in some of the MOPs. So this tool allowed them to ask questions to the tool, as well as to troubleshoot things that they saw in the field. This is a GenAI-based solution that allows you to ask it questions to get real-time answers. It allows you to troubleshoot, and it has an expected 30% improvement in operational time, as well as a 10% in system outage. Now I'm going to pass it on to Waqar to explain the system architecture to you.
Thank you, Robin Sayed. I am Waqar Afzal. I am Senior Solutions Architect in Telco Business Unit. I will take you through the architecture of this solution, and then I will explain the workflow, and then I will come back to a short recorded demo. So let's talk about this architecture. So in this architecture, we are using the virtual private cloud, that is a VPC inside AWS, but that is controlled and completely private for the customer and customer. We are going to use Amazon Bedrock. This is a generative AI service for Amazon that is hosting large language models. With a single API, you have access to multiple large language models. We are using Amazon OpenSearch. We are using a serverless version to make it more cost effective. And over here, what we are using for Amazon OpenSearch for indexing and vectorizing, it is basically used as a vector database. We are using Amazon S3. This is an object storage where operators can upload all the documents. We are using Lambda over here. So Lambda is event-based trigger. Whenever user is asking questions, it will be only triggered at that time. So it will save cost. You are not going to use EC2 instances all the time. We are using this Amazon API gateway in this architecture, but you don't need to use it if you don't have any documents that you need to have access through internet. So all this environment will be completely private in this particular solution. I will talk about the call flow, and we'll talk about the exact embedding models that we are going to use in this solution. So if you see this workflow, the documents that has been uploaded in the S3 bucket, that can include the 3GPP documents, it can include the MOPs, it can include white papers, and it can include any other operator documents that can be root cause analysis, reports, and all those things. Those will be stored in S3 bucket. We will take it, use Amazon Bedrock, and we are using Titan model for the embedding. What embedding will do, it will convert those documents into a numerical representation. Once it will be converted, it will be stored in a vector database, that is Amazon OpenSearch. When user is asking a question, that question is also converted using Amazon embedding model, that is Titan, to a numerical representation. Now you have a question in a numerical representation, you have your documents in a numerical representation and indexed. You're going to do a similarity search. What it will do, it will find the relevant chunks in the documents, and it will feed into this fourth step. What will happen in the fourth step? Now you have your question, your relevant sections from your documents, and you are going to feed this one to large language model. We are using Claude V2.1 from Anthropic over here in this step. And what this will do is this will get the response in a natural language, and it will be intelligent and contextualized response based on your documents, but it will be in a natural language. I'm going to the next step, where I'm going to demonstrate two aspects of this whole optimization. One is when a design engineer want to create an implementation procedure or a mob. So this is a long document. They have to read it, and they have to find out the right parameters to create a mob. In this particular scenario, I will demonstrate that one, and then as well as that particular mob, operation engineer need to execute it in the night. When they are going to execute it in the night, sometimes there can be a newbie operation engineer or can be a seasoned professional, but they might see some issues, some unforeseen responses from those commands. Then at that point, they can interact with this chatbot and they can find it out, the contextualized and right responses of those errors, how to handle it. So in this first one, we are seeing that first a user came over here and he searched for a pre-coding that he want to implement it. He get a summary responses of all the documents that has pre-coding word. Based on that summary, he has selected a document that he want to implement it. And then he started asking questions. How can I implement UE pre-coding feature? In the first one, he was asking, what is a UE-assisted pre-coding feature? Because he probably don't know that. So he will get all those answers over here. Can you provide, the next question he's asking, can you provide me a step-by-step commands to implement this feature? And sometime inside these procedure and pre-checks, there can be some parameter to check. As an example, operation design engineer want him to check the pre-coding is enabled or disabled. And he, or TX muting is enabled or disabled. So he want to make sure he don't know how to check it. So he is asking how to check TX muting, and he is getting commands to check the TX muting. The second step that I'm demonstrating over here is really how to create these mobs. Now this is 300 to 400 pages document, and design engineer want to create a mob to create a DNN in the network. So he is first asking, he is first searching DNN, and he is finding all the relevant documents that has the DNN. He is picking the document that has a configuration and administration guide, and he will ask that how can I create a DNN? Give me a step-by-step commands. The chatbot will provide all those commands step-by-step, including the optional parameters for him to start creating the mob that will reduce his time from 4 hours probably to 5 or 10 minutes to create the mob. And another interesting aspect of it is now operation engineer want to implement this mob. And when he implement it, he probably see a scenario that I implement this mob, I did the post checks, and I find it out that my IPv4 PDN, as an example, is not connecting. What can be an issue? Now, this is just an administration and configuration guide. It is not a troubleshooting guide, but he asked a question that I cannot connect IPv4 PDN. What can be an issue? And if you see over here, it goes to all the sections of the configuration and find it out wherever IPv4 was configured, and it is giving a step-by-step instructions that you need to check on these particular places to make sure that you have configured these parameters correctly. And not only that, it is also realizing that when user is configuring IPv4, it is limited amount of IPs that are configured. So it is instructing that you need to make sure that IPs are not depleted. So it is intelligently giving a troubleshooting response as well based on the administration and configuration guide. Overall, with this all process, we are anticipating that it will improve operation and design staff productivity by 30%, and it will help reducing the operational outages by 10%, and it will improve mean time to resolve the issues in the network. Thank you.